forgiveness. Ask God to forgive you. Let's ask God for forgiveness. All have sinned and come short of his glory. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. Ask God for mercy tonight. Ask God to have mercy on us in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. We receive your mercy tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. We confess our sins. Anything that can stand anything that can block our prayers tonight, Lord, or can stop our prayers tonight, Lord, we ask for mercy. Cleanse us in Jesus' name. Father in heaven, we thank you. We bless your holy name. We're excited to be in your presence. We know that you will do us good in the name of Jesus. Lord, tonight we declare this program open in the name of God the Father, in the name of God the Son, in the name of God the Holy Spirit. Lord, let your will be done tonight. Do us good in Jesus' name. Make everyone who is going through one challenge or the other, make them to testify into your goodness tonight in Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you. We cover ourselves in the blood of Jesus, and we lose your presence over this sanctuary tonight. Lord, do that which you alone can do. Let your name alone be glorified. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen.
Amen. Amen. You are Alpha and Omega. We worship you, O Lord. You are worthy to be praised. And you are Alpha.
Because you're worthy to be praised. Is anyone excited today?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together like this. Yeah.
Yeah.
You never change. Blessed be your name. Soon come a king.
Emmanuel, blessed be your name.
You are the hope of a broken heart. You overcame the grave.
Worship the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Lion of the tribe of Judah. The Bible says, I will bless the Lord at all times, and His glory, His grace shall continually be in my mouth. That means without ceasing, just give Him all the glory. Can I see some hands this morning? Can I see some hands this morning? Does he deserve all the glory? Does he deserve all the praises? Come and give it to him. Hallelujah. You're worthy to be praised. My hallelujah belongs to hallelujah belongs to you. You deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve it. My hallelujah, say.
My hallelujah belongs.
Glory.
awesome is your name. Awesome is your name, Jesus. Awesome is your name. Awesome is your name. Awesome is your name. God, you reign forever. You reign forever. I worship you. And I worship you. God, you reign forever. You reign forever. I worship you. And I worship you. God, you reign.
God, we declare you are the King of all the kings, the Lord of all the lords, the one who is greater than the greatest, the one who is higher than the highest. Tonight we come to worship you. We come to bless your name, O God. Let your glory fill this house tonight. Let everybody be lifted, O God. Let us have an encounter with you tonight, O God. And let your name and your name alone be glorified. We worship and we adore you. In Jesus' mighty name, we have worshipped. Praise the name of the Lord. Let's have our saints. Amen, amen, and amen. Let's give it up even to the choir for that wonderful time in the presence of the Lord. Amen and amen. Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Are you excited tonight? I am so excited tonight. It's not a coincidence that the first Friday in the month of April, today is the 7th of April, right? 1 week is already gone in April, the second quarter. God has kept you, he has kept me. And we are even in the month of Biazo. Hallelujah. It's a great privilege to be in the presence of the Lord, even to be at this service, the prayer and praise night. It's going to be an awesome night, and I want you to be prepared for it. And I'm going to share just a quick scripture with you. We know that the theme of Biazo this year is in his glory. Amen? In his glory. If you open your Bibles very quickly to the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 5, verse 13. 2 Chronicles, chapter 5, verse 13. And if you can put it on the screen, I'll appreciate that. 2 Chronicles, chapter 5, from verse 13. I just want to encourage us with this scripture because I know God is going to do something great and awesome tonight. Amen. The Bible says, 2 Chronicles 5, 13 to 14. It says, it came even to pass, as the trumpeters and the singers were as one, to make one sound to be heard in praising and thanking the Lord. And when they lifted up their voice with the trumpets and cymbals and instruments of music and praised the Lord, saying, for he is good, for his mercies endureth forever, that then the house was filled with a cloud, even the house of the Lord, so that the priest could not stand to minister by the reason of the cloud, for the glory of the Lord had filled the house. Amen. The theme for Biazo is in his glory. And I'm so excited because I know that tonight the glory of the Lord will fill this house as we praise and as we worship him in one accord. Praise the name of the Lord. So I want to welcome you even to this awesome service tonight. I know you have invited people, and if we have anyone who is worshiping with us or who has been invited and is physically here tonight, I would like to recognize that person. If you are in the house for the first time in Jesus' house this is tonight, you've been invited and you've honored that invitation, we'd like to recognize you. If you can please just wave your hands. Anyone in the house? Praise the name of the Lord. We have someone here. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's keep clapping for her. Let's welcome her. Let's welcome her. Let's welcome her. I'm not going to, maybe we should just ask her. We have special seats reserved for her. Amen. We really want to welcome you. We want to make you feel welcome tonight. Amen. Anyone else? Anyone else? Let's keep clapping for her. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. To my dear sister, I want to say welcome once again. This is Jesus House Daisy. We have a special seat reserved for you, if you don't mind. Okay, she's going to be alone. Okay, we don't want you to feel lonely as well. So we just let you bond with your friends. Amen. Hallelujah. But just want to let you know, this is Jesus House DC. It's one of the missions of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. On behalf of our senior pastor, Pastor Gandhi, and Pastor Omo Olaoye, we welcome you to Jesus House DC. Our mission and vision is maximizing potential, restoring hope and maximizing potentials. And we believe that your potentials will be maximized even as you have joined us tonight in the name of Jesus. I believe a card has been placed in your hands. Please take time to fill that card. We want to get to know you better. So all the information you share with us, we promise to keep it very confidential. It's just to get to know you better. I believe we're going to have also a reception for you. So please don't be in a hurry. We'll just have about a few minutes just to meet with you. Praise the Lord. So tonight is a very special night. Like I said, we're going to be having testimonies. Amen. We are going to be having testimony time. And also, I want to encourage anyone, if you have a prayer point, I want to encourage you to please write it down. We have the prayer jar over there. Please take time to write down, you know, those prayer points that you have. And, you know, if you bring it and put it right in the jar there, we're going to be praying over those prayer points. And I know that as we do so, God will answer your prayers speedily in the mighty name of Jesus. At this time, I'm going to open the floor even to testimonies. So if you have a testimony tonight, if you are going to be the first person to share your testimony in the second quarter, anyone in the house? Anyone who wants to share a testimony, We are going to have different sessions, but the first session, I just want to call on one or two people very quickly. If you have a testimony and you are bold enough, I know you have the boldness of Christ. Amen. You are as bold as a lion. Amen. Anyone in the house, don't tell me you don't have it. Praise the name of the Lord. I have a sister. Let's clap for her. Just for about 2 minutes, she's going to share her testimony, even to encourage each and every one of us here tonight. Please, let's give her a mic. Pray. Let's keep clapping for her. The righteous are as bold as a lion. Praise the name of the Lord. Thank you so much. Thank you. Let's keep clapping for her. Let's encourage her. Just 2 minutes, ma. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Well, I thank God on my life today. And it's only by the grace of God. Yesterday, I turned 65.
Oh!
I wasn't expecting, but I trust the Lord that I'll be alive. And I stand before you all, children of God, my family in the Lord, to say I thank God. And I'm testifying. And I'm just saying I'm here just to say thank you for each and every one of you, because you have all touched my life in one way or the other. To God be the glory. Thank you, Mama.
Praise the name of the Lord. Someone else? Okay. We'll take her there, sister. Let's keep clapping for her as well. Let's clap for her.
Praise God. I want to thank God for favor. At the beginning of this year, I was working at a place I didn't like, and I told myself that I was going to quit, and I just suddenly quit without having a plan B. And it was not funny. I was already falling on my savings, and one day I just walked into my bank to make a complaint about something that happened on my account. And by the time I was done with the branch manager, she asked, "Do you have a job?" I was like, "Not exactly." I didn't want to tell her. And she was like, "I think there's a good position that will be a good fit for you." She gave me a card and said I should forward a resume to her. And this same bank, I applied for a lesser position last year. I followed it up. I had the first phase of interview. They never called me. Within 4 days, I got called by the recruiting team, had 3 interviews, and everything was just expedited. That very week, I came to church, and one of the sermons they gave was pastors really talking about giving, giving, giving. So I even gave a tithe, not even having an income. And that was just the beginning. Like, the position I was offered, the benefits, everything is so great. And I'm just here to say thank you, you know. I'm just grateful. And I'm telling anybody, like, if you know your worth and you don't like something, just keep telling God. You know, that's one thing I told God in this land. I said, the silver and this gold belongs of this land. The silver and the gold of this land belongs to me, and I've been enjoying it. Praise God.
Woo, hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Isn't God great? Hallelujah. Wheresoever the soles of your feet shall tread upon. She walked into that bank. She tread on the ground. And what happened? She took it over. Amen. That's the beauty of the God that we serve. We're going to have, you know, more testimonies. And if you have more, you know, your testimonies, we have Sister Laurie at the back. If you could please wave your hands. Please just register your intention with her. We're going to be having different sessions, a second session as well as a third session. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. At this time, we're going to move into a short, a period of, you know, just having a short prayer specifically. And I'm going to call on our dear sister, Deaconess Lide. Or Lide. Stand to be corrected.
Thank you. Good evening, church. Praise the Lord. I just want to welcome everyone again to Biazo 2017. And I believe that all your prayers will be answered in the mighty name of Jesus. I have a very short assignment tonight, and we are going to be praying for salvation, deliverance, and forgiveness of sin. And while preparing for this message, the first thing that came to mind, when people tell you to prepare or pray for salvation, the first thing that comes to all of our mind is we think of unbelievers. And the Lord started dealing with me personally that really salvation is for you and I. What is the meaning of salvation? Salvation is pretty much saving us or delivering us from our sins, you know, and bringing us back to life. And a lot of us, we have the notion that once we've been saved, we are heaven bound. But that's not true, because we can drift out of salvation. Because you are saved 10, 15, 20 years ago does not guarantee that your salvation is still sure. And I pray that that's not going to be our portion in the mighty name of Jesus. When we read 1 Samuel 16, but the Lord said to Samuel, do not look at his appearance or his physical stature, because I have refused them. But the Lord look at the heart. Verse 14 says, but the spirit of the Lord departed from Saul. Saul was a believer. Saul, just like you and I, had the spirit of God in him, born again. But at some point in time, he's still reigning and ruling as king. But the Bible made us to understand that the Spirit of God has departed from him. I might be standing here looking all gay and all of that, but the Spirit of God might have departed. But that's not my portion in the mighty name of Jesus. You might have been coming to church every day, being the pastor, being the worker, what have you. But the Spirit of God might not be in you. I pray tonight that the Lord will restore back our salvation to full measure in the mighty name of Jesus. When we read first Matthew 26:34, Jesus said to him, assuredly, I say to you, that's to Peter, that this night before the rooster crows, you will deny me three times. Verse 35, Peter said to him, even if I have to die with you, I will not deny you. Less than 24 hours, Peter denied him. Peter ate with Jesus. Peter rode with him. Peter was in the inner circle. Peter knew, slept with Jesus, did everything with Jesus. Peter was more righteous than you and I because he was physically with Jesus. But before 24 hours, he denied Jesus. Not only when we say, I denounce you, does it mean that we've denied Jesus. A lot of times, when the Bible says, he that knoweth to do good and does not do it, it's a sin. So I would deny Jesus. He that sees somebody that is hungry, that has not fed him, you have denied Jesus. When I look at my life, when you look at your life, I would deny Jesus. When we give excuses for the things that we're meant to do that we do not do, I would truly deny Christ. I want to call all of us tonight. A lot of us, we are not doing what God has called us to do. We look at the pastors. We look at things around us. It's not about man. It's about God. Two commandments God gave us, to love God with all our hearts and mind, and also to love our neighbors with our hearts. Have we done that? I just want to call everybody tonight. Let's turn around and let's come back to salvation. When we gave our life to Christ, what did we say to Christ? I'm giving you all my life that you be the captain of my life, that you will take control of my life. But a whole lot of us, when it comes to relationship, we tell God, take your hands off the steering. I want to drive that. When it comes to my children, you can handle it. But when it comes to my pastor or my minister, I want to deal with it myself. When it comes to my supervisor, I want to deal with it myself. I'm calling up on us tonight. How many people will want to come back and rededicate his or her life? I'm standing, I'm saying I want to rededicate my life to Christ. If you want to join the prayers with me and say, I want to turn things around. I want to give my all to Christ. I don't want to do this church thing again just by what people are saying, but what the word of God is saying. Let this be as to make a difference. That's the only way we can turn the church around. Can we rise up and begin to pray that I'm coming back, oh Lord and my God. I'm rededicating my life back unto you, that you will fully be the salvation of my life, that you will be the captain of my life. You will take charge of everything in the mighty name of Jesus. I will not handle one thing and leave the other to you. Can you begin to repent and say, Father, I want to turn things around. Father, Lord, let's turn things around. Let's do your work. Let's stop giving excuses. Let's do what God has called us to do. Let me love my mankind, not because they have repaid me good, not because they have done anything for me. Remember, the Bible says that greater works than Jesus did you will do. But you know what? Jesus suffered and went through so much. So how can we do greater work like Jesus
did without going through more than what he did. But I pray that the grace of God will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to confess that, Father, I'm giving back everything to you. You know what it is that you have taken the hands of the Lord from. Is it your career? Is it your education? Is it your business? What is it that the Lord does not have full control of? Let's begin to come back to the Lord right now. Begin to give everything back to him. Begin to surrender everything back to him. Is it that you've been all about yourself? Begin to surrender. Father, your children are crying unto you, Lord, and my God. We are surrendering. We are coming back to you again, Lord, and my God. We are saying, be the Lord of our lives in every situation. Father, Lord, and my God, we know, Lord, you over. Just like Peter, we have denied you, Lord, and my God, in several ways. Is it when we are driving, Lord, and my God? Is it when people offend us, oh Lord, and my God, and we take matters into our hand? But tonight, we are coming, Lord, and my God, asking for forgiveness. We are saying, forgive us and have mercy, Lord, and my God. Show us, oh Lord, and my God, how to do it right, oh Lord, and my God. Help us, oh Lord, and my God, that will not count the cost. But Father, we will stay close to you, Lord, and my God. Father, everyone lifting up their hands, oh Lord, and my God, saying, I surrender completely, Lord. Father, my hands are up, oh Lord. I'm coming back, oh Lord, and my God. I'm rededicating my life. I'm rededicating my service. I'm rededicating my commitment, Lord, and my God, according to your word, not according to the pastors, not according to the ministry that I'm in, but according to your word, according to your leading. Begin to confess that you will guide me, you will lead me, you will show me, Lord, and my God, and that's what I'm going to do. Peradventure, you are watching online, and you do not even know Christ. This is a call unto salvation, and begin to pray. Father, I confess my sins, and I go back no more, and I'm saying, Lord, I'm coming back to a new life. I'm coming back, Lord, and my God, have mercy. Have mercy. Is there someone that is sick in the house? The Bible says that seek ye first the kingdom of God and its righteousness, and every other thing will be added unto you. Because you have rededicated your life tonight, I decree unto you that there shall be salvation, there shall be healing, there shall be deliverance. The Lord shall restore unto you all that you have lost in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to claim them back in the mighty name of Jesus, so that the glory can be to him in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you, Lord, and my God. We will not be the same again, O Lord. We thank you because we will hear you clearly. Why? Because you are the captain of our lives, oh Lord, and my God. We thank you, Lord, and my God. Begin to pray and confess that I will study your word. I will meditate on your word. Do not deny him. I will study your word. I will meditate on your word. I will follow after your leading in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, you can hear your children crying unto you. Have mercy and help me, Lord, and my God. Let that cry, oh Lord, and my God, not go in vain, oh Lord. We thank you. Begin to thank you, the Lord, because he has heard you. Begin to thank the Lord because your life will not be the same. Begin to thank the Lord because he will give you the grace to be different in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to thank the Lord because we're going to change for him in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to thank the Lord because he will guide us and lead us. We are not going to live our life by ourselves anymore. Our lives will be changed in the mighty name of Jesus. People will see Christ in us in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you, Lord. Father, we thank you, Lord. Is there anyone that is sick in the house? I join my faith and I begin to pray. Even as I've prayed the prayer of salvation, that healing has come to you today in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm believing and I know whatsoever that infirmity is, this is not a cliche. I'm confessing and I'm prophesying unto you that healing has come forth unto you in the mighty name of Jesus. I want you to touch your body wherever it is that is aching. Begin to believe that healing has come to you because you have rededicated your mind, your soul back unto him in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, as men are trusting you, Lord, and my God, for increase in whichever way, financially, materially, whichever way, I decree that it shall come to you before the end of this month in the mighty name of Jesus. Not for any reason, but so that the glory shall be to him in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you, Lord. We give you all the praise. In Jesus' name we have prayed. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. We're still warming up. Amen. there's a lot in store for us tonight, and I know that God will meet everyone at the point of their needs in the name of Jesus. It will exceed your expectation this very month of April in the mighty name of Jesus. I want to encourage you all again. We have the prayer jar right in front on the stage. Please, you know, make your prayer request and take time to come and drop it. We're going to be praying on those before the end of the meeting tonight. Hallelujah. At this time, we're going to be having the first performance. I believe they are getting ready for us right now. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. The next guest minister and psalmist and band is a special band that has been invited to be a blessing to us. So with a clap offering unto Jesus, I want us to celebrate Will and Band as they come to minister to us. Brethren, let us welcome them in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Will and Band.
Again, as the mic is on. Praise the Lord, everyone. It's such an honor to be here at the Biazo Conference. Did I say it right? Did I pronounce it right? Thank you, Pastor Andy, for the invitation. And just it's just an honor to be here, just to be before you guys, worship the Lord together. Anybody excited about Jesus? If you're excited about Jesus, come on, just stand on your feet real quick. And in your own way, right? No pressure to be like anyone else. Just give him a few words of worship right now. Come on. Come on in your own way, because he's the King of Kings and he's the Lord of Lords. He's the creator of the world. And it's such an honor, Lord, to be here in your presence, Jesus. It's such an honor to be here. So we have this song, it just says, with my life, I'll scream your name out loud. As Christians and as believers, our only responsibility is to spread the love of Jesus Christ around the world to all who see. And above anything that we can say with our mouths, I feel that our example is just that much more important, right? So the song says, with my life, I'll scream your name out loud. With my life, hey, I'll scream your name out loud. 'Cause you are the one, yeah, true and living God. Scream it loud. So when I say scream it loud, you say Jesus. Okay, so scream it loud. Right here, and Jesus. Scream it loud. Okay, real quick. So I'm going to say scream it loud. The guitar is going to do that little, that he's going to do this. And then you say, so scream it loud. Here we go. Good. Scream it loud. Come on, say it loud. Scream it loud. Last time. Come on, let's start. Let's make some noise for Jesus in here. Let's go. One, two, three, here we go. Scream it loud. Here we go. We have track? We do? All right, cool. Start it. Here we go. Come on. Come on, sound. Come on, clap your hands.
This world that you put us in is changing. You can turn the snare down a little bit. And turning around to the back. This why you put us in to change it. Spread your love, hey, to the nation. So with my life, hey, I'll scream your name out loud. Woo! With my life, I'll scream your name out loud. Yeah, 'cause you are the one. The change of heart pointed to you. We'll glorify your Father with our praise. So with our praise, we'll scream your name out loud.
Anybody excited about the name of Jesus tonight? Come on, say with our praise.
With our praise.
The name above every name tonight. Here we go. 'Cause you are the one true and living God. Scream it loud. What you gonna say? Come on.
Jesus.
Scream it loud. Hey.
Jesus.
Scream it loud. A little bit more mic in this monitor.
Jesus.
Scream it loud. Say it real loud.
Jesus, Jesus, at the mention of your name, every knee will bow and tongue will claim.
You know that song?
Jesus, Jesus, you are Savior, you are Lord, and you are God.
Do you know that tonight?
Jesus, Jesus, at the mention of your name, every knee will bow and tongue proclaim. Jesus, Jesus, you are Savior, you are Lord. You are Savior, you are Lord. You are Savior, you are Lord.
Know that tonight, just give God a shout of praise or a clap with your hands. Anybody know about his love tonight? You don't know true love until you know the love of Jesus. That I know that his love changes everything. And I heard this song a little while ago. It just says,
Lord, you spoke those words. You spoke so tenderly. And now I choose to believe you love me. You love me. You love me.
Simple song.
Lord, you spoke those words. You spoke so tenderly. And now I choose to believe you love me. You love me. You love me.
Is that anyone's testimony tonight?
Taking me by the hand again, giving me strength to dance again. Your love changes everything, yeah. Your love changes everything.
Slow down.
Taking me by the hand again, giving me strength to dance again. Your love changes everything. Your love changes everything. Lord, you spoke those words. Spoke so tenderly, and now I choose to believe you love me, you love me, you love me. Oh, Lord, you spoke those words. Yes, you did, God. You spoke so tenderly. Choose to believe you love me, you love me, you love me.
Feel him taking you by the hand in this moment.
You're taking me by the hand again, you're giving me strength to dance again. And your love changes everything, your love changes everything. You're taking me by the hands again, you're giving me strength to dance again. Changes everything. Your love changes everything.
You know that? Come on.
You're taking me by the hand, giving me strength to dance again. Your love changes everything. Your love changes everything. Taking me by the hand, giving me strength to dance again. Your love changes everything. Your love changes everything. Lord, you never fail. When I look at you, Lord, you never fail. When I trust in you, you never let go.
Woo! that's your testimony. Come on, let's just join in this moment today. Hey, Lord, you never fail. When I look at you, Lord, you never fail. When I trust in you, Lord, you never let go. You never let go of me, Lord, you never let go. Come on, say it again. Lord, you never fail. When I look at you, Lord, you never fail. When I trust in you, Lord, you never let go. You never let go of me, Lord, you never let go. Feel me pulling you by the hand. You're taking me by the hand, yeah. Giving me strength to dance again. Your love changes everything, yeah. Your love changes everything. Strength to dance again. Whoa. Come on, let's say that tonight. Say it. Taking me by the hand, yeah. Giving me strength to dance again. Your love changes everything. Your love changes everything. Your love changes everything. Your love changes everything. Your love changes. When I remove myself out of the way and allow him to show his love to me. And when I found that love, it changed everything about me. Hey. Oh, yeah. Hey. Come on, let's sing that chorus together. Say it, love the music. Taking me by the hand again. You're giving me strength to dance again. Hey, your love changes everything. Hey, your love changes everything, yeah. You're taking me by the hand again. You're giving me strength to dance again. Your love changes everything. 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 Hey, your love changes everything. 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 You changed my heart. Show me what love is, yeah. Oh, when I fall, you're there to catch me. And if I fall again, you're there to do the same. Lord, you keep your eye, grace around me. You'll never leave me. Ooh. For when I fall, you're there to catch me. And if I fall again, you're there to do the same. Lord, you keep your arms around me. And you'll never leave me. We serve a God who said no matter where we were, no matter where we find ourselves, he said he would never leave us nor forsake us. He even went on to say if you laid your own bed in hell, he would still be there. Woo! I just pray that you listen to these words. It says, you're so consistent at being consistent in your ways. And I'm so consistent at being inconsistent each day. I've made the choice to fall many times. to get up and fall again and again while your love shows me how to reach for your hand every time. And I've played around for a while and found life can be no fair. But grace has a way of creeping up when the odds are just not there. You look beyond what I once was, a hopeless tragedy, to step in and capture my heart with love, so constantly and yet free. Though I'll still do wrong, you open your arms. Is that anyone's testimony tonight? For when I fall, you're there to catch me. And if I fall again, you're there to do the same. Woo! Lord, you keep your heart, grace around me, and you'll never leave. It's a chorus. For when I fall, you're there. His word, he promised, his promise in his word are yea and amen. And in his word he said, now unto him who is able to keep me from falling. Am I the only one in here from time to time is just tired of falling into the same things over and over? In those moments I've learned to rest in his promises, so then I made it personal and said, Lord, it is you who is able to keep me from falling. He can do it if you let him. Woo. Lord, it is you, oh, who is able to keep me from falling. Can we say that? Come on, Lord, it is you, say it. Lord, it is you who is able to keep me from falling. You present me faultless. Oh, Lord, it is you. Woo. Who is able to keep me from falling? Falling, Lord, it is you. Lord, it is you. Come on, say who was able, say it. Who is keep me from falling. And when he does, he presents us faultless in the presence of the Father. Come on, let's say it. Lord, it is you who is able to keep me from falling. Oh. This moment, let's just lift our hands to a Father who never keeps his grace from us. His grace is so tangible. It is here for us. Simple fan, but you said, and you'll never leave. let's lift that up tonight. Let's say,
and you'll never leave me. You'll never leave me alone.
Come on, say that. Come on, with thy hands lifted to heaven. Come on.
You'll never leave. Even when I'm wrong.
Come on, let's say it like we know it.
You'll always there, you'll never leave me.
Come on, only if you believe it, say it.
You'll never leave me. When I fall, you're there to catch me. And if I fall again, you're there to do the same. And you're there to do the same. Over and over again. Lord, you keep your embrace around me. Lord, you keep your love around me. Lord, you keep you're around me, yeah. And you'll never leave me. Ooh. And you'll never leave me. You'll never leave.
Come on, say it out tonight.
You'll never leave me. You'll never leave me.
He said to his disciples, he said, lo, I'm with you always, from now even until the end of time. And what I like about that the most, and this is just my own revelation, in his word, he said, I'll be with you even until the end of the earth. And when you look at how the earth is formed and how it's structured as a sphere. So he compared him being with you to something that has no end. And even when you look at it as if, you know, the end of time as the end of, you know, the end of the age, as believers, when it's all said and done, we meet him in eternity anyway. So it's so easy to just bask in his presence and just knowing and being confident that no matter where we find ourselves, no matter where he finds us, he will never leave us nor forsake us. Is that anyone else's testimony in here other than mine? We're gonna sing this last song. It just says,
as we forget the past behind and reach out for your prize alone, the power that gave you life again is that which keeps us moving on. So we look to you, the finisher of the race that's set for us to run, while the cloud of witnesses cheers us on.
That's Moses and Elijah and all of your loved ones that are in heaven.
And she will give grace and strength and keep on running. And I'll just keep running. Running. And I'll never get tired.
That's the whole thing. Come on, sing with us.
And I'll just keep running.
Come on, say that. Run and say it. You sound amazing.
I'll just keep running, and I'll never get tired.
It's our last song, so can you stand with us and celebrate with us one more time? Here we go, start the track. Come on, clap your hands.
Here we go.
a burning desire. And as I'm going, I'll never get tired. Cause you won't let me know. Simple, come on, say it. And I just keep running, hey, as fast as I can. Hey, and I just keep running, and I'll never get tired. Verse 2, here we go. And the cloud of witnesses cheers us on as you give grace and strength to keep on. Hey, anybody ask for the day? And now never get tired. Come on, say it with us, run and say it. Yeah, I'll just get run, here we go. And I'll never get tired. Somebody give Jesus a shout of praise here. God bless you. Thank you so much for having us.
Praise the Lord. Let's give a clap offering to the Lord for the ministry of William M. Band. William M. Band, please put your hands together for Jesus for that wonderful ministration. Two prayers I believe that you should take to heart from those that time of ministration. One is that God will not leave you alone. I expected a louder amen. If you know what it feels like being in the belly of a whale for 3 nights, you will know why it's important to say that prayer. I pray again, the Lord will not leave you alone in the name of Jesus. And you will not get tired while you are running.